yourself back in your dimensional space once again. Harmony of mind, body, and spirit, being here in the now. Our intention is to go to Elysium, a beautiful place of fifth dimensional origin. Focus on your cosmic mind. The cosmic mind knows that we're traveling to Elysium. Then as we take a deep breath, as you exhale, a little you will be inside of your heart space. So take a deep breath, exhale. Out of your physical heart, cosmic heart space. See you, a little you, standing there. You turn and make your way through the threshold to the tiny space of the heart. And there you just stand on the precipice. Your heart intention is to go to Elysium, and to go inside Elysium with an energy vibration of love. And now as you look out through the star field, you see a portal being created. You see the wavy outlines, the flowing rhythms of the light. In the center, it's very open. Kind of has a bluish tint to it. And when you're ready, just step through the threshold and just float in space. And now begin to move toward the portal. Just gliding right to it. And as you get closer, you can feel the energy of the portal. You're just like a black hole. Feels like it just sucks you right into the center. We know that our goal is to go to Elysium, to allow yourself to flow right into that portal. And immediately, you exit the portal. Find yourself standing on a dirt road out in the country. On each side of the dirt road, you can see fields of flowers, grain, fruit trees, and nut trees, fields of flower, green grass, very peaceful. Seems to be a very peaceful agricultural area, but you don't hear any tractors or mechanisms or anything. So begin walking on this dirt road and notice that the rest of us are here together. All seven of us walking along this dirt road. And as we get farther along, we find ourselves catching up with some people. We notice that families are here, adults, children, all making our way down this dirt road. As we come around a curve in the road, we look up ahead and we see there seems to be a lot more people. So we continue our journey. We stay in a place of peace, harmony, love, reverence, and honor. And as we get closer, there's the picture of that stone wall. It almost looks like a castle wall. And Now we see a lot more people all gathered around. Some are sitting around little campfires. Some are sitting on top of the wall, just kind of straddling the wall, but they're not entering. We see some are standing by the front steps, the little portico area there where the columns are that lead into the door. And we get close enough now, we can see that wooden door. So we find ourselves just sitting right there near the steps, close to the door. So we just sit down on the ground, sit in a circle, just in a meditative posture, feeling the peace within, the peace without, the peace above, below, and all around. And now imagine we'll mimic that particular area as we physically tone Om. So let's just do that a few times. Deep breath. Now imagine we just sit in our circle of vibratory love, and as we look all around, we notice that everyone else has stopped moving. They've simply been enchanted by our energy and love of the Om chant, and they understand this energy. And as we still sit in peaceful silence, we hear the door opening. Two or three monks come out of the door, what seem to be in bright orange or burgundy robes. They come and stand right on the top of the steps there. And they speak to us, our group, intuitively, telepathically. And it's only to our group. So we find ourselves standing. We look around and everyone else is still, just standing still. So we make our way up to the steps, the temple steps. The monks bow to us and we bow back to them. They step aside and make a gesture with their hands asking us to enter Elysium. Very slowly, with positive purpose, we make our way up the steps onto the central platform and walk right into Elysium. The monks walk in right behind us and close the door. We stand in the circle and the monks come up and they offer us tea. The monks have tea, we have tea, and we drink this tea together. He speaks to us telepathically with our hearts. We can feel his love. We can feel his joy. Similar to the joy of singing birds. Now the monks usher again with their arms, and we know that we have free rein to explore Elysium. first place we go to, we continue to walk, and we notice off to the right-hand side there, it's like a little shed, or almost like a gazebo, but it has a porch. And as we stand out in front, we notice it says apothecary. And as we get closer to the porch, we notice it looks like a large Chinese apothecary cabinet. So it has a large front face, but it has many, many drawers. It could be a hundred or more drawers. It's made out of this beautiful, shiny wood. Wood unlike anything we've seen on Earth. So if you will, this is a healing spot for you in order to receive some special herbs and medicines that you may need for your specific health and wellness for your 3D body. So when you're ready, just walk up to in front of this cabinet up on the porch. And when you do, look at all the drawers, and you'll see the drawers light up like bright light. And that drawer or other drawers will open up. And these are the herbs for you. So do this now. Remember that the apothecary is here at all times. So when you return to Elysium, you may approach it at any time. Just stand in front. You cannot enter Elysium without an open and loving heart. So the energy here knows that you are pure in love. So now take your herb information with you. Need to bi-locate, come back to your 3D body, and we'll write that down. You can, because we're multi-dimensional shamans. Or just remember what the herbs or spices or liquids or foods are for you. And now imagine us walking away from the apothecary, and as we stand there and look all around, we notice there are buildings everywhere. And we see a lot more people. We see ascended masters walking by that we may recognize from reading ancient texts, scriptures. And as we look off to the left, we hear a little bit of joyousness and happiness coming from this area. And as we look at it, we notice it's a very long house made out of wood, something that seems to be rather rustic, a beautiful shade of wood, maybe a various shade of cedar. So we make our way to the longhouse. As we get closer, we can smell these wonderful aromas. And we know that this is a place of festivities, food, and drink. And as we get closer, we can hear the laughter, the joyousness, and the good times. So we'll make our way to the door. As we get closer and we enter, there we see a hall with long chairs, tables, maybe 100 feet long, filled with many, many people, laughter, eating, drinking together, truly brotherly and sisterly love. As we walk in, everyone stops and feels our presence. They look at us. At that point, someone begins to walk towards us. ushers us to a place within this longhouse. Because they've been waiting for us. So now as we begin to be ushered, the rest of the crowd goes back to being happy and joyous, having their conversations. As we make our way through the crowd, we see people that we have seen before. Maybe in our dreams, or memories, or meditations, or 3D visualizations. We're placed at a table and whatever we'd like to eat or drink. It's brought right away by a wonderful wait staff. They place the food in front of us. And we look around. People come up to us. Begin to talk, listen, laugh, and truly enjoy the fellowship of being here. Feel the joy of fellowship and oneness, wholeness. Now remember the energy of this space, the joyous and happiness, fellowship energy. A place where we can meet anyone we wish to meet. We simply think and they are here. And now we find ourselves standing up and making our way out of the longhouse, saying goodbyes along the way, because now we know and we've met everyone telepathically. We know who they are. They know who we are. We find ourselves back out in the front again in the common area. And as we walk away from the longhouse, we look ahead and we see an area that has some palm trees and these beautiful azure pools. Even more than an azure color, a little bit of green turquoise mixed in. Looks like something from a very exotic Egyptian or Atlantean type pool of water. And as we get closer, we notice that people are sitting on the edge of this pool, feet dangling in the water. And we notice that this is the goddess pool. So find ourselves walking up to this pool. Look for the goddess that attracts you or the goddesses. And have a seat between them. Feel the coolness of the waters on your feet, your legs. And just spend a little time with the goddesses on to your left and to your right. Before we leave the pools of Atlantis, I want you to imagine just looking down into the water at the reflection. So as you stop moving your feet and legs in the water, allow the water to get very still, look down and see the reflection of you. Especially look at your eyes. Notice how your eyes have this radiance about them.
This is the happy, blissful, and excited you. This is the radiance that is within you. The awesome, beautiful, perfect. Everything is one. Everything is love. Everything is light. All is love. Remember this radiance in your eyes. Carry it back with you to your 3D body. And now with this quick trip with the goddesses of Atlantis, now arise and begin to walk back towards the longhouse. And as we get into the common area there, look to the right. And up on the hill, we see what looks like a little diner or a cafe. And we see a sign that says TAC. This stands for the Ancient Cafe. So make your way up to the Ancient Cafe on this little hillside. Notice how the little area, the little sidewalk has these little beautiful flowers. Flowers unknown to you in the earth physical plane. Almost similar to the flowers that you would see in the movie Avatar. And now we kind of go in. When you do, the door has that little bell at the top and everybody knows we've entered. And this is the place where we meet the ancient ascended masters. So it is here that you may see and meet with Jesus, Buddha, Mary Magdalene, Thoth, She said, those wife. So as we sit down at this beautiful table, just look around and see all of these beautiful ascended masters gathered in one place. And when you're ready, you may get up and go over and sit with them. Have a cup of coffee or tea. Just be with them for a few minutes. You can do this now. Notice that when you communicate telepathically, you receive millions of bits of information within a few seconds. It's all understood. Now we finish ourselves standing up once again, a very short trip, but yet we received and gathered lots of information telepathically and spiritually with our cosmic mind, cosmic heart, cosmic spirit. We say our goodbyes for now, but we know that we are in wholeness forever. So we make our way out of the Ancient's Cafe. We leave through the door, make our way back down the hill. Come out to that common area. And up ahead, we see the gate, the front gate that we entered. And as we look right above the gate, we see that blue sphere that we saw on the slide. And we see the heart that's right in the very center of that. That will be our exit and entrance point from now on. So Whenever we return back to Elysium, we simply glide through this blue sphere with a heart, and we'll be on the other side of the door. So now, when you're ready, as we stand there together in the circle, imagine we just lift up off the ground. And we fly and move right towards that blue sphere. And as we do, as we come out the other side of the blue sphere, there we are. In the star field. Tiny space of the heart. We begin to hear the rattle that helps us to hear and to vibrate back to our physical heart. So we follow the sound of the rattle, and up ahead there is the threshold that leads back to our physical heart. We find ourselves going back through the threshold. We enter our physical heart. Make our way back to the center of the heart. Now we connect our cosmic heart with our cosmic mind as we remember everything, every piece of information that was telepathically uploaded into our essence, to our vibratory field, stored in the cells of our physical body. Will be transferred there so that we may remember and recall this energy, this knowledge, this wisdom. And now imagine us moving back fully into the cosmic mind. And you can feel your body once again. Notice your breathing once again. Move your toes and fingers. And quickly come back to full consciousness, fully alert. Just take a deep breath, open your eyes, and make any notes.